My name is Alexandra, and I work at the Toronto Public Library, and I'm here to welcome you to Mini Makers at Home. Mini Makers is a program that we offer at some of our libraries, and it's a program where we explore STEM concepts with the young learner. STEM stands for something special. Do we remember what it is? Let's say it together. Science, technology, engineering, and math. Today, I will be showing you how to make your very own catapult using simple objects from your home. Parents and caregivers, I invite you to do this activity with your child. It's a lot more fun this way. Now let's get into what a catapult is. If you haven't heard of a catapult, that's okay. A catapult is a special device that is used to launch an object in the air. How far the object travels, or the distance, is a result of energy. When you prepare to launch an object, you're zapping it with energy. Though you can't actually see or feel this energy, but you can see what the result is, meaning you can see what happens. When you add energy to an object and then you let it go, the energy is released and then transferred to the object, which then flies throughout the air. This is why catapults can make their objects travel really far and powerfully. Now that we've talked a little bit about the science behind catapults, we're going to put our engineering hats on and learn how to make our own. To make your catapult, you will need large or small popsicle sticks. If you don't have popsicle sticks, you can even use a few pencils secured with elastics or tape, a plastic spoon or a bottle cap. If you do use a bottle cap, you would need glue to glue it onto the popsicle stick. Elastics. Regular or hair elastics work. You can get these with food sometimes even. I got this blue one with a head of broccoli. The packet of tissues is an option for the inner part if you don't have enough popsicle sticks. Objects to launch. Pom-poms work great, but if you don't have those, you can use cotton balls, balled up aluminum foil, scrunched up paper, a button, a small toy, anything that is lightweight but won't hurt anyone, of course. If you decide to draw a target, you'll need paper and pen or a pencil or a crayon and some tape. Start by stacking two popsicle sticks, then place your spoon over one of the popsicle sticks so the bottom of the spoon is directly aligned with the end of the two popsicle sticks you stack together. Pinch the popsicle sticks and spoon together while you use your elastic to tie around the bottom of your creation until it's nice and tight. This might be a two-person job. Next, take about five popsicle sticks or your packet of tissues. If using popsicle sticks, stack them up evenly and use one elastic to tie around one of the extremes nice and tightly. Then use the other elastic to tie around the opposite extreme. Leave about an inch between the elastic at the end of the popsicle sticks so the elastic doesn't become loose. Grab your spoon and popsicle stick combination and open up the popsicle stick part. It's going to feel quite tight. Slip the stack of five popsicle sticks in between and slide it right to where the angle starts. It might slide a little bit while you're testing it, but it's easy to adjust. Here's an example of what the last step might look like if you were using a packet of tissues. To draw your target, you can use the large side of a bowl to trace the outer circle and the small side of a bowl to trace the inner circle. It doesn't have to be perfect though, so you can just experiment with drawing the circles like I ended up doing. Now it's time for the fun part, testing our catapults for the very first time. When you push down on your catapult, try pushing down in different ways. Try lightly and try harder. See what difference that makes when you launch the object. Think about how that might change how the object flies. When you get the hang of it, join me for some challenges. My goal is to hit the target I made. Do you think I'll make it? I didn't, but that's okay. I will keep testing, just like you should keep testing your catapult to see how much you can control the launch. Your first challenge is to make an object your target and launch your object at the target. If you can do this outside, great. If not, you can try launching it down a hallway or a part of your home where you don't have other objects getting in the way. If you're not creating your own target, use tape to mark your goal on the floor or put a bucket or bowl where you want the object to land. For your second challenge, try putting your catapult on top of something else to give it some height, like a stack of books. Do you see any changes? Think about why that might be. After you're done your challenges, try thinking of your own. And don't forget to check out more Mini Makers at Home videos brought to you by the Toronto Public Library. Thank you so much for watching and building with me. And until next time, bye for now.